As our celebration begins, let's join in singing a hymn of glory. Let us sing. A hymn of glory, let us sing. New song throughout the world shall ring. Alleluia, alleluia. Christ by a rope before untrod, ascended to the throne of God. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
Apostolic band upon the Mount of Olives stand. Alleluia, alleluia. And with his faithful followers see their Lord ascend in majesty. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
amen.
Grace and peace to you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ.
And with your spirit.
Beloved, we prepare to celebrate the great mystery of our salvation in Christ in this Eucharist, commemorating the solemnity of the ascension of the Lord Jesus Christ, body and soul, into heaven. We prepare our hearts for a more worthy celebration and encounter with the Lord, recognizing and acknowledging our sins, knowing and trusting in the mercy and love of God. Let us now submit ourselves to him for healing, forgiveness, and strength. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill.
For you,
we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ.
with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. Let us pray. O God, whose Son today ascended to the heavens as the apostles looked on, grant, we pray, that in accordance with his promise, we may be worthy for him to live it with us always on earth and with him in heaven, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the first Act of the Apostles. In the first book, Theophilus, I dealt with all that Jesus did and taught until the day he was taken up. After giving instructions through the Holy Spirit to the apostles whom he had chosen, he presented himself alive to them by many proofs after he had suffered, and appearing to them during 40 days and speaking about the kingdom of God. While meeting with them, he enjoined them not to depart from Jerusalem, but to wait for the promise of the Father, about which you have heard me speak. For John baptized with water, but in a few days you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit. When they had gathered together, they asked him, Lord, are you at this time going to restore the kingdom to Israel? He answered them, it is not for you to know the times or seasons that the Father has established by his own authority. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and you will be witnesses in Jerusalem, throughout Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. When he had said this, as they were looking up, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him from their sight. While they were looking intently at the sky as he was going, suddenly two men, dressed in white garments, stood beside them. They said, Men of Galilee, why are you standing there looking at the sky? This Jesus, who has been taken up from you into heaven, will return in the same way as you have seen him going into heaven. The word of the Lord.
God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the
God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord.
All you peoples, clap your hands. Shout to God with cries of gladness. For the Lord, the Most High, the Awesome, is the great King over all the earth.
God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord.
God mounts his throne amid shouts of joy, the Lord amid trumpet blasts. Sing praise to God, sing praise. Sing praise to our King, sing praise.
God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord.
all the earth is God. Sing hymns of praise. God reigns over the nations. God sits upon his holy throne.
God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, may the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation, resulting in knowledge of him. May the eyes of your hearts be enlightened, that you may know what is the hope that belongs to his call, what are the riches of glory in his inheritance among the holy ones, and what is the surpassing greatness of his power for us who believe, in accord with the exercise of his great might, which he worked in Christ, raising him from the dead, and seating him at his right hand in the heavens, far above every principality, authority, power, and dominion, and every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in the one to come. And he put all things beneath his feet and gave him his head over all things to the church, which is his body, the fullness of the one who fills all things in every way. The word of the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia.
I am your servant, Lord. Speak to me. You have the words of everlasting life.
Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the conclusion of the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory
to you, O Lord. The 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain to which Jesus had ordered them. When they saw him, they worshipped, but they doubted. Then Jesus approached and said to them, "All power in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. And behold, I am with you always until the end of the age." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. For those of you who are wondering what this solemnity, this feast of the Ascension, is all about, it is about when Jesus started to work from home. You can laugh if you want. Jesus decided to start working from home. And there is some truth in that. But they say that home is where the heart is. Home is where the heart is. And I think that phrase is a beautiful way to understand, in as much as we are hearing descriptions in the writing of the Acts of the Apostles, and it may be somewhat puzzling for us hearing the Gospel of Matthew, which presents us what is known as the Great Commission, we would say, well, Father, where does the Gospel come from? It says nothing about the Ascension as such. That's true. Matthew does not have an account of the Ascension as such. But Holy Mother Church has presented us with this particular, the end of the Gospel of St. Matthew, because as far as Matthew is concerned, Matthew is wanting to communicate two realities. If you go to the beginning of the Gospel of Matthew, what do we hear? We hear about the account of the birth of the child Jesus. And we hear about how Joseph is given insight as to how the child was conceived. Remember, Joseph was struggling with taking Mary into his home, not understanding, knowing he had no relations with her. And he was told about how it came to be, in that this child shall be called Emmanuel, which means God with us. And so the church wants us to hear very clearly in the conclusion of this Gospel of Matthew, behold, I shall be with you always until the end of the age or until the end of the world. He is with us in a very real way, and he's with us everywhere we are, at every instant. There is never a time where Jesus is no longer present to us, very much personally within us, in the spirit, now that he has moved beyond time and space. He's moved beyond history, and because he's beyond history, he's returned back to his Father. And when we say he's ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father, that is not to say that he's taken on a posture of passivity where he's not involved anymore. No, it's to be understood. When a king is victorious, when a king goes out into combat and comes back victorious, he sits back upon his throne where he reigns. In essence, this solemnity is highlighting how Jesus is now governing the works of salvation from the seat of glory with his Father. As they've sent forth the Holy Spirit, as that interior, if you will, that spiritual intelligence, huh? That gift to us to be able to think with the head, with the mind of Christ, to see with his eyes, hear with his ear, love with his heart, move with his zeal, and operate in a manner that is about reconciling God with all of creation. This feast is significant in that all of that holds true. But there are some significant facts that are pointed out to us from the writing of the Acts of the Apostles. The Acts of the Apostles is oftentimes referred to by scholars and theologians as the Gospel of the Holy Spirit. It is volume 2, if you will, of St. Luke's writing of the Gospel, his Gospel, and then the Acts of the Apostles. He mentions in great detail, he gives us the full presentation of what happened at the Ascension. Jesus, after appearing for 40 days, the number 40, very significant. Recall, if you go to Genesis chapter 7 and 8, it highlights about 40 days where the rains came down and the entire earth was flooded during the time of Noah. And it was for that purpose, so you hear of the age before the flood and the age after the flood. And that was a way in which God allowed the earth to be purified. It was a way of purifying the earth of its sinfulness at that time. We also know that 40 was significant with regard to Moses atop the mount as he was receiving the law of God. Jesus himself was led into the desert where he was in a state of preparation and testing, where he was being tempted and tested for the work of his public ministry, 40 days in the wilderness, in the desert. Elijah, also 40 days every time. So the number 40 speaks of a time of purification, preparation, transition. So, and we can see in Jesus, in what was he also having, and in the very same way, we could say for these 40 days that he was appearing to them, very much so, the resurrection, the Feast of the Resurrection, commemorates the time when Jesus, his body was reunited with his soul, glorified mind you. He had a glorified body, a body that was no longer subject to the natural order. He was now able to appear in ways that people could see him and recognize him, and in ways that he would be somewhat veiled from them. He simply had to think about where he wanted to be, and he was there. So it's a preview of what you and I will receive once we die and our soul is brought up and we receive a glorified body. But we won't receive glorified bodies until the end of all things. Consummated. The only other person in heaven with a glorified body is the mother of Jesus. Mary was assumed. She was taken up into heaven, body and soul. But again, to confirm for us what we have to look forward to, God has the power. Jesus, as he says in the gospel, all power in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go ye therefore into all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. So, the number 40. The second thing about it is they saw him go up in the clouds. Into the cloud. He was taken up in the cloud. The cloud is to be understood as the Shekinah, the glory cloud. It always highlighted God travels on the clouds. Elijah was taken up into the fiery chariot. But God, it's also to confirm Jesus is the Son of God. He is fully human, fully divine. And he rides amidst the cloud. He's taken up in the cloud. Psalm 104 celebrates and speaks of how God travels on the cloud. Also, I believe the book of Daniel signifies a prophetic word. It presents a prophetic word speaking about how the Son of God will come on the clouds. So that's also significant. He didn't just disappear. And the idea of heaven. What is heaven as Scripture speaks of it? They saw him go up into the heavens. Well, Scripture brings us to understand it in the same way we understand. The heavens are that visible realm where we see the blue skies, the white clouds, the stars, the constellations of the heavens, the Milky Way, all of that. But then as we hear it here, heaven, as Pope Emeritus Benedict XVI states, heaven isn't so much a place as much as it is a person. When Jesus ascended back from whence he came, he opened a pathway for us, a pathway in which you and I now, when we think of heaven, all of heaven is in Christ himself. So when he says, I shall come back again and take you to myself, he promises he will bring us to be with him. That is heaven. When I'm lifted up, I shall draw all things to myself. Again, confirming the reality of himself as the God of heaven and earth, and he is the witness. He is the faithful one who came that we may have life and have it to the full. The 40 days, the cloud, the Shekinah, the glory cloud, and of course, entering into heaven. And as we are finding ourselves here, we may wonder, how is it then that we are able to maintain this work of the Lord? He speaks about being witnesses, a witness. Think about the events in the life of Jesus where there were two witnesses in addition to whoever else might have been in the gospel scene, such as Peter, James, and John. At the Transfiguration, we were shown there was Moses and Elijah, Peter, James, and John, two witnesses. At the Resurrection, we're told there were two mysterious figures, the two angels, two men dressed in white to greet the women. Why are you looking for the living amongst the dead? He is not here. He has risen just as he said. And then finally, we hear of the disciples looking up into the heavens. Men of Galilee, these two men dressed in white, why are you looking up into the sky as you are? This Jesus whom you've seen going up into the clouds, he shall come back in the same way in which you have seen him go. In other words, it's time to get to work. We have to go and be about the work of the Master. He's entrusted us. As we have become witnesses, it's not just so much that Jesus has ascended, because some people often try to object to, if you will, the idea that Jesus is resurrected. Some in the world will say, some atheists and so forth will say, or skeptics rather will say, well, if Jesus resurrected from the dead, then where is he? Why is he not here? Why can't we see him? St. Thomas Aquinas, anticipating such objections would be raised, he deals with this notion. And he says that the primary reason why Jesus ascends into heaven in the way he does is so that he could increase our faith, our hope, and our charity. Blessed are those who have not seen and yet believe. Also, it's to also confirm, as the Catechism says, in the section of the Catechism, paragraphs 645 to 663, the humanity that Jesus assumed is irreversibly united to the divine nature forever, for all eternity. And whenever we gather as we do in every Eucharist, as we are today, we are uniting ourselves to Jesus, the high priest, who entered the sanctuary, not made by hands, but entered into heaven itself. And what is he doing? He is eternally offering the sacrifice to the Father. And when we come in, we do it sacramentally with him. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. We say that during the Hosanna, preparing us for the moment of encounter where heaven literally kisses earth in every Eucharist. So yes, as significant as it is for you and I to receive tangibly the elements of the body, blood, soul, and divinity of Christ under the appearance of bread and wine, it's even more significant that in light of what we've received, we make every effort necessary to give ourselves back to the one who gives himself to us in every aspect of our lives. And for that to be done in full, it is necessary for the Holy Spirit to accompany us. As he accompanied the church then, he continues to accompany us now. For as Jesus says, behold, I shall be with you always until the end of the age. God love you. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. The disciples devoted themselves to prayer in the upper room. Let us, too, join together as disciples, lifting our prayers to the Lord.
For the church on earth, may God increase her in holiness. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
Hear our prayer. For world leaders who follow the example of Christ, may God help them in their service to their people and the kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. For Christians throughout the world who are suffering for their faith in Christ, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. For the intentions of this Mass, the needs of the people whose names are written in the Hear Our Prayer book, and the prayers we hold in the silence of our hearts, united with Our Lady of Perpetual Help. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. For our faith community, rejoicing as an Easter people, may God bless our efforts to protect the dignity and sanctity of human life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. For those who have died in faith, especially Malvina Rodriguez, Thomas Casey Goodwine, and Jerry Ann Haynes, may they rejoice in the light of God's glory. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. Through the intercession of St. Roch, for those who are suffering in the current outbreak of sickness, that they might be healed. And for those who have died from this sickness, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. For those who have lost their lives defending our country, that they may have eternal rest. And for their families, that they may know God's comfort, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us now entrust these petitions given voice with those we harbor in the silence of our hearts to the faithful and powerful intercession of the Immaculate Heart of the Blessed Virgin Mary, our perpetual help, as we say. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Heavenly Father, please hear and answer our prayers, spoken and unspoken, in your wisdom, according to your plan for us. For we ask this through your beloved Son, Jesus the Christ, our Lord, living and reigning with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
During the preparation of gifts, let us raise our voices in singing, Go Make of All Disciples.
Go make of all disciples, we hear the call, O Lord, that comes from you, our Father, and your eternal word. Inspire our ways of learning through earnest, fervent prayer, and let our daily living reveal you everywhere. Go make of all disciples, baptizing in the name of Father, Son, and Spirit, from age to
pray, beloved, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, whose only begotten Son, our High Priest, is seated ever living at your right hand to intercede for us, grant that we may approach with confidence the throne of grace and there obtain your mercy through Christ our Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your Spirit,
lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For the Lord Jesus, the King of glory, conqueror of sin and death, ascended today to the highest heavens as the angels gazed in wonder. Mediator between God and man, judge of the world and Lord of hosts, he ascended not to distance himself from our lowly state, but that we, his members, might be confident of following where he, our head and founder, has gone before. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world. Together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Gregory, our Bishop, and all those who hold into the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise. For them we offer you the sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. Celebrating the most sacred day on which your only begotten Son, our Lord, placed at the right hand of your glory our weak human nature, which he had united to himself, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers and all things we may be defended by your protecting help through Christ our Lord. Amen. Therefore, Lord, we pray graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands. And once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
A mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the blessed passion, the resurrection from the dead, in the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance and to accept them, as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing through Christ our Lord. Amen. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith, and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the crucified, risen, and ascended Lord Jesus Christ be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Receive the body of Christ. Let us join in singing, "Here I Am."
Dwell in dark and sin. My
For those not able to receive Jesus now in the most blessed sacrament of the altar, we offer the following prayer. Soul of Christ, sanctify me. Body of Christ, save me. Blood of Christ, inebriate me. Water from the side of Christ, wash me. Passion of Christ, strengthen me. O good Jesus, hear me. Within thy wounds, hide me. Suffer me not to be separated from thee. From the malicious enemy, defend me. In the hour of my death, call me and bid me come to thee, that with thy saints and angels, I may praise thee forever and ever. Amen.
Let us pray. May the gifts we have received from your altar, Lord, kindle in our hearts a longing for the heavenly homeland and cause us to press forward, following in the Savior's footsteps to the place where for our sake he entered before us, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit. Bow down your heads and pray for God's blessing.
May Almighty God bless you, for on this very day his only begotten Son pierced the heights of heaven and unlocked for you the way to ascend to where he is. Amen. Amen. May he grant that as Christ, after his resurrection, was seen plainly by his disciples, so when he comes as judge, he may show himself merciful to you for all eternity. Amen.
Amen.
And may you, who believe he is seated with the Father in his majesty, know with joy the fulfillment of his promise to stay with you until the end of time. Amen. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen. Amen. Go forth, glorifying God by the way you live your lives.
Thanks be to God.
Please remember to take the song sheets with you when you leave. And as we go forth, we will sing together America the Beautiful in remembrance of all those in our military who made the ultimate sacrifice in defending our country and also for those who continue to serve this great nation.
Oh, beautiful for spacious skies, for amber waves of grain, for purple mountain majesties above the fruited plain. America, America, God shed his grace on thee and crowned thy good with brotherhood from sea to shining sea.
Beautiful
for heroes proved in liberating strife, who more than self their country loved, and mercy more than life. America, America, thy God thy gold refine, till all success be nobleness and every gain divine.
Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl around the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Amen.